Home location register
This
visitor.
call is now being recorded.
Okay, we'll start the point number two, that is signaling protocol architecture. Signaling protocol architecture. What is signaling protocol architecture? Is nothing but what? For connecting the any call, for getting any of the signals, we require some of the entities or we require some of the parameters. And those parameters or those protocols has to be used for connecting the call. And those parameters or those protocols are nothing but whatever we have seen in the GSM network architecture, those protocols has to be, you have to do the continuation. In that, sub entities or sub parameters is going to support for signaling purposes. So what are this? You are seeing this here, that is a signaling protocol architecture. We are using the four main entities, that is of MS, the mobile station, BTS, base transceiver station, BSE, base station controller, and MSC, that is mobile switching center. In this main protocols, we are using the sub protocols. We are using sub protocols. For mobile station, we are using the three layers. That is of layer 1, layer 2, and layer 3. Layer 1 is of physical layer, layer 2 is of data link layer, and layer 3 of consists of some of the respondents or some of the connection between the two devices, connectivity between the two devices, how the signal is going to connect between two devices, that has to be taken care by this layer 3. That is MS. We'll see one by one. The layer 3 is having the three main aspects, that is of CM, that is connection management. Second is MM, that is mobility management. And third is radio resource. What is the main function of this RR? Radio resource is nothing but what? For a radio resource, we have to connect a particular signal to the other end of the user. Radio resources. You have to access a particular channel from the MSC. After accessing that particular channel, that has to be taken care by this accessing the network. Next, mobility management. It has to manage all the connections. Mobility management function is to manage all the connections which are connected properly or not. That has to be taken care by this mobility management. Mobility is nothing but what? Seamless connectivity. Seamless connectivity means what? There is no any disturbance between any of the call. There is no disconnectivity of the call. That has to be taken care by this mobility. Connection management. Connection is nothing but what? You have to connect. You have to connect for two different layers. You have to connect the two different calls. That has to be taken care by this connection management. He has written here the GSM signaling protocol architecture for mobile station is having a three layers. One is of layer 1, physical layer. Physical layer is nothing but what? Your wireless devices. Okay, that has to be used. That information has to be spread through air. That information has to be spread through air. That has to be taken care by this physical layer. Layer 2 is of data link layer. Data link layer is to be taken care by this. There is no noise has to be present in between any of the signal. There is no noise has to be present between the any signal. That has to be taken care by this layer 2. And I already explained that is of layer 3. Layer 3 consists of connection management, mobility management, and radio resource management. The radio resource has to access the channel and it has to help for connectivity of a call for accessing the channel. Mobility management, that is a seamless connection between the two channels, has to be taken care by this mobility management. And last is connection management. You have to connect for one end of the user to the other end of the user. That has to be taken care by this connection management. And you are seeing here in the diagram, there is a connection between the two protocols, that is from MSC is connected to BTS and BTS is connected to BSC and BSC is connected to the MSC. There is an interfacing. What is interfacing? Meaning is what? For example, I will give the example, that is your charger is there and you have a mobile. Your charger pin is going to connect to your mobile. That is what interfacing. That is what interfacing. Your charger pin is going to connect to your mobile slot. That is called as interfacing. You are going to interfere with each other. That is what MS is going to connect with the BTS. BTS is connected with the BSC and BSC is connected with the MSC. And there are number of short forms will become in this. You have to remember the full form of these short forms. What is MS? MS is of mobile station. BTS is of base transceiver station. BSC is of base station controller. And MSC is of mobile switching center. And we have seen the MS protocol. And MS is connected to the BTS. When connecting the MS to the BTS, we are using one interface, that is of UM interface. U/M. Remember this. This will comes in MCQ. This will comes in MCQ. Fixed question for this MCQ. The MS is connected to BTS through the interface of which interface? That is of UVM. And BTS is connected to BSC through the interface of A BIS. If you want, you can write it. This will be very helpful for MCQ question. And BSC will connect to the MSC, and the interface between the BSC and MSC is of A interface, capital A interface. You have to remember, these are the main MCQ questions. MS to BTS, interface is of UM. BTS to BSC, interface is of ABS. And BSC to MSC, interface is of A. And written, and I have written the all the four forms here. What is LAPD? Link access protocol for D channel. Different channels we are having. Different channels from A to Z. So then LARPD, that is link access protocol for M-Link mobile. Different mobiles are having a different channel. So that has to be used. And the full form for M mobile message transfer part. Whenever you are sent any SMSs, that has to be taken care by this MTP, message transfer part. Next, SSCP, signaling connection and control point. While connecting any of the signal or any of the call, you have to control. Controlling is very necessary for connection of the call. There are many multiple number of users are going to connect to the different vendors or different users. So you have to control almost all the calls for connection of the call to the individual user. That has to be taken care by this SSCP, that is signaling connection and control point. And last is BSSAP, that is base station subsystem application part. We have already seen this base station subsystem in GSM network architecture. What is the main function of this base station subsystem? This base station subsystem or a station is having its own subsystems, that is of BTS, base transceiver station, and the BSC, that is base station controller. And the BTS to the BSC interface is of ABS, and BSC to the MSC, the interface is of A interface. So what is the main important point? You have to see the interfaces. That is MS to the BTS. What is MS to the BTS? That is from mobile station to base transceiver station. What is the main importance of this? In this, we are using three layers. Already we have seen. Which are the three layers? One is a radio resource, one is mobility management, and last is your connection management. These are the three aspects we are using for connection of the call. What you have to do for mobile station to be base station, base transceiver station? Main, the function of this mobile station is to access the network, is to access the channel. After that, accessing the channel, it has to connect to the particular end of the user. After connection, the seamless connectivity is required. There is no disconnectivity in between the call. That has to be taken care by this MSC, that is mobile switching center. And if once the connection has been done, you have to manage almost all the connections before connecting the call. Before connecting the call, and MSC has to do almost all the processes, that is to check the HLR, that is where the person is located, where is moving, and is authenticated or not. Everything has to be checked before connecting the call. That has to be function has to be done by MS to the BTS. Once the BTS signal has to be moved, that is the protocol has been taken place, that is the BSC protocol is going to work. What is the main function of this BSC? BSC is nothing but what? It has to have the power control. It has to taken care of power control. How much power is required? How much power is required for to connect particular call? How much power has to be allocated to the particular base station or a tower? All the information, all the decision has to be taken care by this base station controller. The interface between the BTS to the BSC is what? That is of A-BIAS interface. A-BIAS interface. Controlling function, almost all the controlling function means what? The many of the communication, the many of the calling control, call control has to be done this from BTS to the BSC. That has to be done in this BSC protocol. And MSC, you already know what is the main function of MSC, that is a mobile switching center. What is the main function of MSC is, MSC is whenever user wants to access any network, any user wants to access any network, for accessing any network, he required a channel. That channel has to be allocated by this MSC protocol. Okay. Once the permission has been given for accessing the network, the MSC will check all the information of the user who is going to allocate the particular channel to the user. That means what? MSC will connect to the HLR, MSC will connect to the VLR, MSC is connected to the authentication, and MSC will connect to the equipment identity register, that is of EIR. It has to check almost all the information. It has to check almost all the information. Means what? Home location register, where he is located. Visitor location register, where he is moving from his location to another location. That has to be stored in VLR, and that information has to be given to the MSC. And equipment identity register, it has consist of three lists. One is white list, one is gray list, and one is black list. And it has to be checked the user is in which list. The user is in which list. If he is in white list, immediately the call will be connected. If the user is in gray list or black list, he is blocked. He is blocked, so connection will not be done. So that has to be taken care by this equipment identity register. After this, the authentication is very, very important. Authentication is very, very important. Means what? Whenever you are going to purchase a SIM card, the key is stored. That is of 16-bit key stored in your SIM card. The same 16-bit key is also stored in MSC, that is mobile switching center. Okay. If the key matches, the user is authenticated. If the key matches, the user is authenticated. If the key does not match, user is not authenticated. So almost all the processes has to be taken care. So almost all the process has to be taken care by this MSC protocol. So this is the concept of a signaling protocol. This is the concept of signaling protocol architecture. You have to write for a MCQ point of view. You have to write the interface. This is very, very important. That is from MS to the BTS. From MS to BTS, the interface is of UEM interface. And from BTS to BSC, the interface is of ABIS. And from BSC to MSC, the interface is of A interface. Okay. This is what the point number two, that is signaling protocol architecture. And this is very, very important. You came to know how your mobile number is going to specify, how your mobile number has to be finalized. So GSM identifier. Identifier is nothing but how the person is going to identify, how the user, the mobile is user is going to identify, how the person is going to track based on this. Very, very important and interesting. There are number of identifiers they have mentioned. Means what? It is in short form. You have to, those short forms has to be mentioned in full form. That is the first identifier. The first identifier is of MSISDN. Total 7 identifiers are there. By using all these 7 identifiers, they are going to identify particular user and particular person. So very interesting. So MSISDN, this is the first identifier. Means what? The full form of this MSISDN is Mobile Subscriber Integrated Service Digital Number. MSISDN, Mobile Subscriber Integrated Service Digital Number. Means what? Your contact number. You are having your contact number that is of 10 digit. Okay. That contact number of 10 digit is composed of, the 10 digit contact number is composed of, that is of CC plus NVN. CC stands for your country code. CC stands for your country code plus NVN stands for national valid number. Means what? You are adding plus 91. You are adding plus 91 before your 10 digit mobile number. Okay. CC stands for your country code plus NVN stands for, that is national valid number, that is of 10 digit number. Okay. You can take any of the any 10 digit number of your mobile number, that is he has it, I have written here, that is plus 91 99 15 155 31 200. This is what? The one of the mobile number. Plus 91, I already told you, that is plus 91 is your country code. Plus 91 is our country code. Plus 91 is our country code. Next two digit, next two digit out of 10 digit of our mobile number, the first two digit is of MSCID. MSCID is nothing but from where you are located, from which state you are, that has to be mentioned in first two digit number. Next three digit number, that is of HLRID. What is HLR? Home location register. That is where you are located. You are from where you are from. Means you are from Maharashtra state, you are from Maharashtra state, you are located in Pandharpur or in Solapur or any of the talukas or any of the villages. That has to be registered in this value. And next last five digit is of your serial number. That is a random serial number has to be allocated to the individual user. Got the point? How they are going to finalize the mobile numbers of this? How they are going to finalize the mobile numbers means what? Where you are going to purchase, in which state you are going to purchase your SIM card, and which address proof you are showing for purchasing that SIM card, and last five digit is of serial number, random serial number. Okay, plus 91 is your country code, and last 10 digits are that is of national valid number. First two digit, that is of MSCID, next three digit is of HLRID, and last five digit is of your serial number. So that is what they are. If you want to track any person, if you want to track any user where he is located, by using this method, by using this identifiers, they are going to track a particular person. That is what first identifier. Second identifier is what? IMSI. IMSI, that is International Mobile Subscriber Identity. IMSI is nothing but what? International Mobile Subscriber Identity. दिस इंटरनेशनल मोबाइल सब्सक्राइबर आइडेंटिटी इज कंपोज्ड ऑफ दैट इज ऑफ सिम कार्ड इन योर सिम कार्ड MSISDN एंड IMSI प्रेजेंट इन योर सिम कार्ड व्हाट आर द टू कैटेगरीज आर प्रेजेंट इन दिस वन इज MSISDN एंड ऑफ IMSI MSISDN is of 10 digit number, IMSI is of 15 digit number. How they are going to define this 15 digit number? That is of MCC, mobile country code. Mobile country code, that is of 3 digit. MNC, mobile network code. That is next is MSIN, mobile subscriber international number. That is of your 10 digit mobile number. 15 digit, how it becomes 15 digit? Mobile country code for India, the country code is of 3 digit, that is of 404 or 405. For India, the country code is of 404 or 405. MNC, that is mobile network code, that is of 2 digit. Mobile network code that is of 2 digit means you are operators. Operators are nothing but what? You are using an Airtel SIM card. You are using Jio SIM card, you are using Vodafone, you are using Jio. That is nothing but what? Operators. Different operators are using different codes. So that is what? Mobile network code. MSIN, mobile subscriber, international number, that is of 10 digit. That is 10 digit will be vary from 00 to 999. So this MSISDN that can be, IMSI can be used for authentication and verification purposes. Okay, this IMSI can be used for authentication and verification purposes. This is very, very interesting and very, very important point. How to define the particular 10 digit of our mobile number, how they are defining the particular IMSI, how they are going to identify a particular person or a user, that has to be taken care by this identifier. Third identifier is TMSI. TMSI is nothing but what? Temporary Mobile Subscriber Identity. What is TMSI? Temporary Mobile Subscriber Identity. Means what? What is the main function of TMSI? Whenever you are changing the location, whenever you are changing the location, you are going to change the IMSI. That is International Mobile Subscriber Identity. Okay, you are changing from one cell to different cells, from different cells to different of cells. You are moving from Pandapur to Solapur, Solapur to in other state, district. That has to be stored in this. Changing locations by changing the IMSI. So main function of DMSI is temporary. Temporary is nothing but what? The person who is located in that area, he is not present in that particular area, he is moving. He is moving for a number of places or locations. That has to be identified by using this TMSI, that is Temporary Mobile Subscriber Identity. And the next identifier is MSRN, Mobile Subscriber Roaming Number. Mobile Subscriber Roaming Number means what? You are exchanging MSRN. Exchanging MSRN means what? When we are getting the roaming, when we changed a border or we are moving from different states, that is what? You are moving from Maharashtra to Karnataka, you are getting the roaming. At the top, at the corner of your mobile, you are getting capital R. That is what? Nothing but you are in a roaming means what? You are from one MSC to the other MSC. You are moving from one state to the other state. In that state, the exchange has to be taken place. That is what? Subscriber roaming number has to be taken place. Means what? You are going to allocate for that network. You are going to allocate for that network. You are for allocating for a particular network. You have to register. You have to register for that particular network. So when you get a roaming, immediately you have to change your mobile settings that you have to register for a particular network in that particular state. So that has to be taken care by this mobile subscriber roaming number. You are exchanging the MSRN number. When you exchange the particular MSRN number, your roaming will be decreases. Otherwise, your data will be lost in a fraction of seconds. If you just on the data, if you are in a roaming, in a 10 to 15 minutes, your data is closed. So you have to take care when you are in roaming, you have to register for that particular network where you are located. So this is very important. That is MSRN. BSIC. Next identifier is BSIC. That is base station identification code. Base station identification code. So in a different location, there are many number of base stations we are having. Each base station is having its own code. Each base station is having its own code. We can't see that particular code which is present at that base station. All the base station, the respective codes has to be present at the main offices. At the main offices means what? They can easily track a particular person. They easily track a particular vehicle. They easily track particular ships. They easily track a particular aeroplanes, army people. Everything that has to be used in this base station identification code. When they are using the base station identification code, they are going to mention a colors. They are going to mention the color, that is NCC and BSC. NCC and BSC, that is network color code, base station code. The network color code and base station code is of 3 bits. That is of 3 bits. Whenever you are changing the locations, that is cell identification. Okay, you are moving in the same Maharashtra itself, there are number of base station you are changing. You are moving from one taluka to other taluka. That is to be used in a different base station. Okay, that has to be used for this BSIC. Different identification codes has to be allocated to the individual base station. That has to be used in this base station identification code. Next identifier is CGI. CGI is cell global identity. Global is nothing but all over the world. By using your mobile, you can move through all over the world. That is, identified can be used, identifier can use this identification process, that is of CGI, cell global identity. This cell global identity is having different parameters, that is of CC. Already I told you that is CC full form is country code, MNC mobile network code, LSE location area code, a CI cell identification. Getting the point? Cell global identity. CGI stands for cell global identity. CC stands for country code. MNC stands for mobile network code. LSE stands for local location area code. And CI stands for cell identity. So what is this? Country code for India, that is of +91. You are in India, you are using the SIM card as Airtel. Your respective state is of Chandigarh, that is you are present in this particular area. So how they are going to identify a particular person? They are going to identify a particular respective person based on this CGI, that is cell global identity. Country code, mobile network code, location area code, and cell identification. Means what? In India, the respective person is using the Airtel SIM card. He is from this state. He is located in this location. This is what a routine. India is using a Jio SIM card. He is present in Maharashtra and he is present from Solapur. So that has to be identified using cell global identity. And the last identifier is of IMEI. What is IMEI? International Mobile Equipment Identity. Means what? When they are going to integrate, when they are going to manufacture a particular mobile, when they are going to manufacture a particular mobile, this identification process has to be used. IMEI, that is International Mobile Equipment Identity. Equipment identity is nothing but what it is attached to the network. That is of consists of TAC, Type Approval Code, FAC, Final Assembly Code, SNR, Serial Number, SP, Spare Bit. What means what? Whenever any mobile has to be manufactured, it required approval. It required approval. The device we are using means what? Different Samsung is there, Redmi 5 Pro, 7 Pro, 8 Pro, 12 Pro, different sets are there, different mobiles we are using. That has to be required approval. Based on that approval, they are going to modify that particular mobile type, which type we require. Redmi 5 Pro, 6 Pro, 7 Pro, 8 Pro, 9 Pro, 12, 13. So this is what different devices we are using nowadays. That has required approval. That is of IMEI is total of 15 digit. 15 digit. It is a permanent number. It is not a temporary number. When manufactured your mobile, that 15 digit mobile manufacturing mobile manufacturer number has to be installed in your mobile. That has to be installed in your mobile. Which mobile is this? Is this Redmi 5 Pro? Is this Redmi 6 Pro? 7 Pro, 8 Pro. That is a 15 digit number, mobile number. Based on that, they are going to identify this is of Samsung mobile, this is of Redmi mobile. Everything has to be approved by using this particular code. Final assembly, that is FAC, stands for two area. Final assembly is nothing but where it is to be manufactured, where it is going to be manufactured, in which area it has to be manufactured, in which area it has been assembled. That has to be used in final assembly code. After that, the serial number has to be assigned, that is of 6-bit. Serial number has to be assigned, that is of 6-bit. And the spare bit, if you want to increase any inbuilt data, okay? If you want to increase any inbuilt data that is applicable for your mobile for increasing the data rate. So this is what, how they are going to identify particular person or particular mobile in a different country. So these are what some of the identifiers we are using. You have to remember this for identifiers. One is MS-ISDN mobile. If you want, you can write it MS-ISDN. Second is IMSI, just a minute.